thing, and then we can come up, we dance, 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 and we continue to acknowledge the Lordship and the grace of God in the life of the celebrant of today. Right about now, listen to the man who is 82 today, but in his mind, he is just 28. Ladies and gentlemen, an icon of our time, a great philosophical man, whose composition will definitely bring morals, enlighten you, inspire you, and of course, make good success. Celebrant evangelist professor Ebenezer Obey Family FFR.
And I considerato the only moment I have today. You still find time to be here today. And really, really appreciate your presence here. Senior Kennedy and the board members, all the media who are here, and Senior Ishoya, all of you, I appreciate all of you. I want to thank you for this big surprise. I cannot thank you enough. And I know that you will clock 80, 90, 100 in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Papa, I know all of you. I'm only a new one. You have always been there for me. Anytime, any day. I really, really appreciate you. My brother, Babu of Ebola, Chief Abolia Kwani, I appreciate all of you. I want to read the scripture that will help me to express myself the purpose of this Thanksgiving. Before I read these scriptures, I'm very happy that the doctors and representatives of Kilena Hospital, where I had the surgery, in Lagos here. I'm very happy that they are here too. And I appreciate you and I recognize you. I just have to read some 92 from verse 1-4. That will really, really help me to express myself. Some 92 from verse 1. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises on the holiday for us now, to show forth thy loving kindness in the morning and the faithfulness every night upon an instrument of blessings and upon the suffering upon the harp with the solemn sound. And last but not least, for thou, Lord, hast made me glad through my work and triumph in the works of thy hands. Here, I have just expressed myself in the Sabbath for verse 1-4. All my life, the Lord has been so good to me. All my life. I started music while I was right from the beginning of my home. My mommy was carrying the pregnancy of the parents to the church. And I was born into the church and I was attracted by the choir, especially by the instruments. And I used to crawl to let the choir was having their instruments. And my mom told me that as I crawled to the choir instruments, my mommy would run to carry me and I always crawl back there. And the pastor of that church took me for my mom. In known position. And that prophecy came to pass in my life. I became a professional musician at the age of 15, precisely in the year 1957. That's when I had my first one. I thank God for all that the Lord has done for me. very happy that my brother, Reverend Iguanma Shamu, is here. And I know that later on, we would like to hear Reverend Iguanma Shamu's voice. So I thank God that God has seen me through several surgeries. In 1980, I had a surgery in London. There was a complication of God's surgery. But this prostate enlargement, that was the last surgery that I did in Tulane Hospital. Kalina Hospital. Prostate enlargement is a disease that is meant for men. A man from the age of 40 can be affected by prostate enlargement. So it's a good thing that I have in the pipeline a record that I'm preparing to release to educate parents, to educate people about the disease called prostate enlargement. I was here all the time having a thing about because I was in the hospital before I entered the center. I was in the hospital, you pray for me. And when I come out from the center, you pray for me. I thank God that I will see God answer your prayers. Not only say no. Pastor Ayo, Pastor Kumoni, Pastor Iwani Mashaw, and many, many, many great men of God, including Reverend Asimomale, who actually came all the way from the Lord to visit me in the hospital three times. I was thankful, I was appreciative for all of you who prayed and fasted for me to have success on this surgery. I was afraid and I thought I was going to die. I thought I was going to die. Really, I was here and when we had the first surgery, it was successful. But there was need for the second surgery because there was blood clot. The blood allowed urine to come out. And going through the ordeal of the second theater scared me so much that I thought I would be able to make it. But God, again, intervened, and I am here. And I said yes. Usually when I have my money, I usually have one in the one in the time. But knowing the good of the nation and in order to be part of what we are all going through in Nigeria, I decided to just have this time today and give palliatives to various people. We have been doing that. We have done that in our church before today. We are doing another one in the world today. We have different locations. And later after this, we are going to have a certain school of the blood. That was how God led me. I will thank God that God answered the prayers of all the children of God. Here they are, giving thanks to God and saying, thank you to God. I must thank you. I must thank the cross distribution, all the pastors, all the elders, praying and fasting. And I must, on behalf of the elders, I must use Elder Honorable Grimo, Elder Honorable Babatunde Adebayo and Elder Usra, Elder Akaradido, Elder Olasoye, Elder Baribo, our leaders, Elder Adeboye, Elder Ujati. I will use all of you because I cannot mention you all. To appreciate you for all that you did. And God, I will actually answer our prayers and we will continue to answer our prayers in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to especially again, always send the Baruch of a black man to Kabisi over a little of my wife who came before. And I really appreciate the Lord. I know the Kabisi would have been here, but I was the one who said, well, he's a Muslim and he's including the Ramadan. So I thank God for everything. I cannot do without mentioning Shimonuja Mokoshoa, former governor of the state, who visited me in the hospital 5 times. And he brought the good message and the package of His Excellency
intentionally leave the Accra as the last customer.
Buffalo, head of nine. You are always wonderful. You are always there. Yesterday was your birthday, and today is mine. And you are here today. I appreciate you. I will continue to appreciate you because you are special in the kingdom.
But the way His Excellency did two powerful tracks there, I professor did your excellency, move out. Right from the beginning to the end. Bishop Kabe 50. Very shortly, watch out for the news. But ladies and gentlemen, to give the vote of thanks at this time, join me to welcome His Lordship Bishop Afolani Obi Fabidi.